Around the planet, only some of the youngest impact craters, such as Meteor Crater in Arizona or Lonar Lake in India, are well known. Yet, despite the vast amount of erosion and the ever-changing landscape of the planet, there are several impact craters which are more than 1 billion years old. Two of these craters are only known because they are truly massive and responsible for large platinum ore bodies, such as the 1.85 billion-year-old Sudbury Crater in Canada. However, within Australia, there is another ancient impact crater which few people are aware of. What is being shown on screen is the remnants of a 1.63 billion-year-old impact crater, which can be roughly made out from satellite data due to the circular ring-like structure in its center. Known as Shoemaker Crater, this massive feature formed at a time when Earth contained no plants, no animals, and no fungi. This video will discuss this crater, which was named after the famous planetary scientist Eugene Shoemaker. The Shoemaker Impact Crater is located in the central section of Western Australia. Specifically, it is 105 kilometers northeast of the city of Wiluna. This 30-kilometer-wide impact crater originated 1.63 billion years ago when a 2,600-meter or 8,530-foot-wide asteroid was on a collision course with Earth. Known as a Type Ci carbonaceous chondrite, this asteroid was a member of the first group of asteroids to form during the beginning of the solar system 4.57 billion years ago. As this asteroid entered the upper atmosphere, it was traveling at 18 kilometers per second or 40,000 miles per hour. A bright streak of light soon became visible as the asteroid continued its descent. At this stage in Earth's geologic history, there were very few complex life forms on the planet. Although life did exist, it largely consisted of blue and green colored cyanobacteria. Sometimes, large colonies of these primitive organisms would group together to form mound-like structures called stromatolites. At the time, the planet had 18-hour days and there was only 5% of the levels of oxygen in the atmosphere today. A few seconds later, this asteroid impacted the surface, generating a massive explosion equivalent in energy to the detonation of 784,000 megatons of TNT. This pulverized a large section of crust, causing underlying rock to act like a viscous liquid as it propagated up and down like a wave, while also instantaneously creating a series of large fault lines. This sloshing in mere hours created a resurgent peak within the crater. As a large fireball was created on impact, a magnitude 8.5 earthquake was generated. Simultaneously, due to the immense heat and thermal radiation generated by the impact, any life forms in a 500-kilometer radius faced an intense 160 degrees Celsius heat. This was hot enough to immediately ignite any pure sulfur crystals within this radius. 25 minutes later, a 180-kilometer-per-hour wind would reach the edge of this radius, thus kicking up large amounts of dirt. The loud boom of this explosion would later be heard around the planet. The newly formed crater measured 30 kilometers wide and 820 meters deep. In its center, a large pool of molten rock had been created, which superheated large quantities of underlying granite. This pool of material would later go on to form scattered deposits of copper, silver, and lead minerals through the creation of minerals such as chalcopyrite and tetrahedrite. In the many millions of years since, the top of the dome eroded away, leaving behind a ring structure. It is largely filled with beautifully colored yellow and green salt lakes, which contain these unusual colorations due to high concentrations of certain microbial life. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.